All right, well, let me digress. Do your thing.
All right. So what I wanted to say is that so a lot of diagnoses that people are given by allopathic mainstream medicine are actually, you know, they keep increasing diagnoses and creating new diseases and adding new categories. But I want to say that actually most of these things are really the same thing. They're just that in individuals, because of individual circumstance, they might manifest differently. So for example, like autoimmune diseases. So like you could have a diagnosis of Crohn's disease or fibromyalgia or rheumatoid arthritis or lupus or scleroderma. But in my opinion, those are all actually the same disease, just manifesting in slightly different parts of the body, depending on your individual circumstances. And in my view, there are really just what I would say five causes of illness. And one of the first one is malnutrition. So there's some nutrient that you're depleted in. Secondly would be toxicity, and that would include like chemical toxicity as well as like exposure to various types of radiation, ionizing and non-ionizing radiation. And most, in my experience, most people who come to me for information, they have a combination of malnutrition in certain things and toxicity from other things. Then we have psychological shock, and this often plays a part in both physical and psychological problems, and can cause a purely physical disease and can be caused purely by a physical cause like toxicity and malnutrition. Then we have trauma, like I'm talking about physical trauma, not psychological, because that will go with the psychological shock. So this is, you know, you have an injury, a car accident, a cut, a scrape, a broken bone. And then the last thing, which is the most rare cause of disease, is a genetic anomaly. And so, you know, you might be familiar with diseases like Tay-Sachs or cystic fibrosis, and that's what's in that category. Definitely less than 1% of all illnesses, probably much lower than that. So that's the kind of framework really to cover the cause of all disease, whatever the diagnosis may be. So a lot of times when I talk about one thing and I give some information about how you might address that, it would apply to other things in that category as well. And then I want to talk just a little bit about the contagion and terrain theory type question. And of course, you know, it would take me quite a while to really go over terrain theory, so I'm not going to do that here. But I want to just propose that the microorganisms in our body play a role to help us recover from illness rather than being the cause of it. And that's essentially the main thing that distinguishes terrain theory from germ theory. But let me talk about contagion for a minute, because I know that this is a real sticking point in letting go of the sort of germ theory idea. And what I want to say is that if there's really no proof of a microorganism causing the disease, then you really know right there that contagion doesn't occur, because what are you then passing back that's causing the disease between people? And it's important to know that in other cultures, like Chinese traditional medicine, for example, which evolved over thousands of years, the wisdom contained in it, and I'm certainly not an expert in it by any means, I only know some very basic principles, but in Chinese traditional medicine, they have no conception whatsoever of contagion. And yet they've observed the same illness pattern in people throughout the millennia. So we've been strongly conditioned to worry about getting sick and passing illness between each other. And I think that's the reason why it's so hard to overcome for most people. But